Gentleman from California, for as much time as he may consume.
Thank you very much, Madam Speaker. I rise today in support of H.R. 3336, the Small Business Credit Availability Act. The bipartisan measure received unanimous support in the House Committee on Agriculture and ensures, as the previous speakers have indicated, that small financial entities such as community banks, farm credit system institutions, credit unions will not be burdened with costly regulations resulting from the reform of our financial system. That was never Congress's intent. I appreciate very much Chairman Lucas and Ranking Member Peterson and their staffs for working with, as well as the bill sponsor, Representative Hartsettler, to reach an agreement with not only myself, but my colleagues, Congressman Baca, Cardozo, who are also on the committee, as well as the California delegation, on the underlying text of this bill. Without your supports, obviously, we could not address this issue pertaining to California. And while we work to maintain the viability of the small businesses recognized in H.R. 3336, we also must look for ways to avoid the unintended consequences resulting from the implementation of the Dodd-Frank Act on other entities, in this case, such as utilities. And it's always the difficult challenge we have in Congress, the law of unintended consequences that we must respond to. Because of California's regulatory environment, I expressed concerns in the committee that California's energy providers, our utility companies, might be or would be inadvertently, as we believe, swept up by the swap dealer definition, which is the efforts that the committee has addressed. Over several weeks, we worked together with the staff and the utilities to ensure to develop language that provides the clarity needed to ensure that companies within California that provide energy for all businesses and residences, which are ultimately California's ratepayers, are not penalized by the federal regulators for simply complying with state law. H.R. 3336 includes language clarifying that the actions undertaken to comply with state or local laws or regulations are excluded in determining whether or not an entity is considered a swap dealer. Let me be specific. The language clarifies that, one, resource adequacy contracts entered into satisfy California's Public Utilities Commission procurement requirements. Two, renewable energy credits used to satisfy California's renewable portfolio standard. Three, and emission allowances to satisfy California's greenhouse gas regulations should not, and this is the key line, should not be considered in determining whether or not an entity is a swap dealer. For my colleagues, we should understand that the situation we're dealing with in these examples, these transactions are closely regulated by the California's Public Utility Commission or the California Air Force Air Resources Board, and they pose no systemic risk to our financial systems or to the ratepayers. While California is currently affected, it is possible that these concerns could be shared by energy providers in other states, and that's why the committee in their wisdom chose to address this issue and to help not only California, but possibly its extent to other states that might be similarly affected. For these reasons, I encourage my colleagues to support this bill, and I yield back the balance of my time, and I once again want to thank the chairman, thank Ranking Member Peterson, Chairman Lucas, and the author of the bill, Representative Hartsettler. Thank you very much.
Gentleman from